Mr. Haney.
Where do you want me to dump the stuff?
Well, you... wait, I didn't order that.
Correct. It was ordered by the Monroe brothers.
Oh? Well, just a minute. wait, Mr. Haney.
Here, what are you unloading that stuff for?
Well, like I said, they ordered it.
What for?
You want to tell him, Sam?
No, you tell him, Irving.
Mr. Haney, put that stuff back on the truck.
Well, they ordered it.
You know why we ordered it?
I really don't care. I've lost interest.
You'll be interested when we tell you. Tomorrow, we are going to finish your bedroom.
What? We'll be here first thing tomorrow morning, tacking up the chicken wire and nailing up the lath.
And by noon, you'll be plastered.
Hey, that's pretty good, Brenda.
Thank you, Covina.
Oh, boy. Do you hear that? They're finally going to finish the bedroom. I can hardly believe it.
Here's your bill.
I can't believe that either. $700.
Is that all it is? My bookkeeper must have made a mistake.
She certainly did.
It does seem cheap, doesn't it?
Well, all there is some chicken wire, some plaster, and some tar paper. Can't cost more than $40.
Then why did you get a bill for
$700? Yeah, that's what I'd like to know.
I'll be glad to ask my bookkeeper as soon as she gets back from her vacation in Acapulco.
Mr. Haney, if you want to get paid, you give me an itemized bill.
There you are.
What the?
Something wrong?
This one's for $900.
That's right. 700 unitemized, 900 itemized. Itemizing runs high these days.
Yeah. Well, I'll give you $40 for the material.
What about the trucking charge?
Well, how much do you think that's worth?
$660.
I'll pay you $10 for the trucking, $50 altogether.
Mr. Douglas, I can't...
Do you want the 50?
No, I guess I'll have to take it. I'm a little short of cash. And I owe the fellow at the lumber yard $12 for this stuff.
Howdy, Mr. Douglas.
Hi, Mr. Haney.
Anything I can do for you?
No, Oh, wait a minute. There is something you could do for me, yes.
You just name it, and I'm sure that I've got it on my truck.
No. I want to ask you a question.
The Haney Information Service stands ready to help.
Has anybody been looking for a little boy that ran away from home?
They sure have.
Who?
My mother.
What?
I ran away from home when I was 3 years old and become a traveling dicky salesman. I was a Western representative for Dingwell's non-wilt dicky.
Mr. Haney, I've heard enough wild stories for one day. Has anybody around here reported a missing boy?
How big a reward is offered for his return?
There's no reward.
Then I ain't heard a word.
Will you excuse me?
You're going into Drucker's to buy jeans for little Al Hamilton?
You were listening.
You were yelling. Now, I can save you the trip to Drucker's. Have you had time to read the sign?
Yes.
Then shall we examine the merchandise?
Listen, I'm not interested. Is that the junk you're trying to sell me?
No, it's the other junk I'm trying to sell you. You will just sit down. I'll have the clothes modeled for you. Now, this is a copy of a genuine imitation of an original Parisian design stolen by...
I'm looking for something for an 8-year-old boy.
You couldn't get anything better for an 8-year-old boy than little Nancy.
Mr. Haney, you're...
Now, this is our junior executive model, as worn exclusively on Madison Avenue. It comes with an imitation leather attache case, and
Mr. Haney, I believe I've seen enough.
Mr. Douglas, I like a buyer that makes up his mind quickly. Shall I wrap it up for the lad?
You should be ashamed of yourself using these little children to shill for you.
Mr. Douglas, these two are students of the Haney School of Modeling. They're getting a little professional experience.
Professional experience.
All right, kids, change your clothes and have your 50 senses ready for today's lesson.
How do you do? Does Mr. Douglas live here? until the divorce.
Beg your pardon?
Well, you can't expect me to live with a man who would ruin a company just to prove that I don't know how to invest $28.
I'd appreciate it if I could see Mr. Douglas.
What about?
I have a warrant for his arrest.
Oh, just a second. Oliver, there's a man here to arrest you. Oh, you better stand aside. He'll be coming out running.
Who's going to arrest me?
This man. Oh, excuse me, I didn't get your name.
Malone.
Oh, Oliver, this is Mr. Malone, the man who's going to arrest you.
Mr. Douglas, I'm with the FCC, the Federal Communications Commission.
Mm-hmm.
I have a warrant here charging you with running an illegal television station.
You just can't stay out of trouble, can you?
Lisa, please, just go into the house. Now, what is this nonsense about me operating an illegal television station?
There's no sense in denying it. WPIXL-TV, that's the station in Pixley, made a recording of your appearance last night when you cut in on their frequency.
I cut in on...
You got undressed right in the middle of their Richard Dix festival.
Howdy, Mr. Douglas.
Mr. Haney, this gentleman...
I'll just take a second. I just want to give you your $4.18 royalty for the sale of 12 polka dot shorts as featured on your undressing show last night.
Oh, doing commercials, eh?
No, I didn't do any commercial.
Mr. Douglas, now, when you go on the air tonight...
I'm not going on the air tonight.
After the rating you got?
Rating?
The Hooterville Overnight Nielsen. Just listen to this. Number one... Man undressing show. Number two, man doing barnyard imitations. Number three, Beverly Hillbillies. Now that's tied with the WPIXL test pattern.
Oh, peddle your shorts.
Now the dispensing motion has been made. All in favor, raise your hand. Motion's carried. Now to get to the important business. The Hooterville Volunteer Fire Department meeting is open for discussion. Mr. Douglas?
Gentlemen, I don't think it's any secret that our fire department is a disgrace. It's inefficient, it's ill-equipped. In the event of any emergency, it would be completely impotent. Not only...
Is that word impotent?
Yes.
You spell that with an I or an E?
An I? What are you doing?
Just looking up the meaning of that word in this new handy pocket dictionary, which I am offering today for only $1. It contains 20,000 words, most of which can be used in polite society. Haney?
Mr. Haney, may I please continue?
Oh, go right ahead.
As I was saying, our fire department is outdated. We need equipment. We need instruction. In other words, we need to completely overhaul the Hooterville Fire Department.
I agree. The chair will now entertain a motion to fire Joe Carson.
Oh, wait, gentlemen, I...
Motion's made.
No,
I... All those in favor?
No.
Motion carried. Joe's fired. Now, the next order of business is the new fire chief. And since this ain't going to be an easy job, I think it's only fair that we ask for a volunteer for the job.
Mr. Drucker.
Mr. Douglas, we accept your volunteering.
No, but I...
Hail to the new fire chief. Hail, hail! Hail, hail! Hail, hail!
Oh, hail!
Hold it right there, partner.
Mr. Haney, point that gun somewhere else.
Oh, it ain't loaded. Gene Autry made sure of that when he sold it to me. You see, he can't use it no more now that they don't allow violence on TV.